الحمد لله الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك ومجدك لا نحصي ثناءً عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وقائدنا وحبيبنا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله رسول الله وعبده بلغ الرسالة أدى الأمانة نصح الأمة كشف الله به الغمة وترك الناس على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك ولا يتنكبها إلا ضال عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي المقصرة بتقوى الله لقوله في كتابه يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون اعلموا أن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار عباد الله my dear brothers and sisters in Islam Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us in many many verses in the Quran many ayat to be grateful to him As he says in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَاشْكُرُوا لِلَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ إِيَّاهُ تَعْبُدُونَ Be thankful to Allah if you truly worship Him. So the essence of ibadah, the essence of worship is to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, what does that mean to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What's the meaning of gratitude? Especially within this time of the year when the people are celebrating Thanksgiving. It's going to be on coming Thursday. So how we can understand that, how we can define the meaning of shukr from Islamic point of view. Ash-shukr, my dear brothers and sisters, means idhhar ni'mah, showing the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon you. Through what? Through a statement, or an action, or even with conviction in your heart. أن تظهر النعمة بقلبك بلسانك أو بحركة تتحرك بها And we recite every single day in Surah Al-Fatiha the second verse الحمد لله رب العالمين You thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى Right? But what's the difference between hamd and shukr? There is a difference between both of them. As the scholar said, Alhamdu yakunu fi muqabili ni'ma wa yakunu biduniha. The hamd, the word hamd, when you say alhamdulillah, it could be in return for a favor or blessings or not. But it's not like the shukr. Unlike the shukr could be only in return for a favor or blessing. That's why in one of authentic hadith, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Alhamdu ra'su shukr. Like praising to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like the head of thanks. فَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْمَدِ اللَّهَ لَمْ يَشْكُرُ. The ones who don't do hamd, they are not doing shukr exactly. So the hamd is more comprehensive than shukr. And when we come to the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon every one of us, could we count these blessings? The first thing, we have a lot. But even with the technology we have right now, could we count these blessings that everyone has? No. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that clearly. In the Quran, 2 times, He says, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you're gonna count the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon you, you would never able to number them. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ends the ayah with إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah is the most merciful, most kind, because He knows that you can't count the blessings that He bestow upon you. Neither you can't thank Him as He deserves. So He is Ghafoor Rahim. That's why it's a sunnah to say dua, to supplicate Allah after every fard prayer, every fajr, dhuhr, asr, maghrib, and isha, to say, Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrik wa shukrik wa husni ibadatik. Oh Allah, help me ala dhikrik, to remember you, shukrik, to thank you, husni ibadatik, to worship you properly. Because without Allah's help, you can't do that. You can't worship Him. You can't thank Him. So you always has to ask Allah to help you to worship Him and to thank Him. Because at one moment, on the Day of Judgment, you're gonna be questioned. Have you offered enough hamd in regard of the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon you in this life or not? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Takathur, ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. You're gonna be questioned. Ibn Kathir said in the under the interpretation of this ayah, he said, ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَنْ شُكْرِ مَا أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ. On the Day of Judgment, you will be asked, when you're gonna stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for thanks in regard of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had bestowed upon you in this life. عَنْ شُكْرِ مَا أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنَ الصِّحَّةِ وَالْأَمْنِ وَالرِّزْقِ وَغَيْرِ ذَلِكِ. From health, security, livelihood, and many, many other blessings. So the questions, my dear brothers and sisters, are we ready for that? Have we prepared enough for that question? In another word, how can we prepare for that question? How can we be among the ones who are thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, among the shakirin and hamideen for the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon every one of us? Ibn al-Qayyim said, قَالَ أَشُكْرُ يَكُونُ بِالْقَلْبِ خُضُوعًا وَاسْتِكَانًا. Shukr, showing gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, could be by heart, in submission and humility. وَيَكُونُ بِاللِّسَانِ ثَنَاءً وَعِرْفَانًا. And it could be by the tongue in praise and acknowledgement. قَالْ وَيَكُونُ بِالْجَوَارِحِ. By action, طَاعَةً وَانْقِيَادًا. When you obey the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are three pillars of shukr. Heart, tongue, and actions. And when we come to the first one, which is the main important one, the qalb, the heart, how could be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How could show the gratitude by the heart? I have. You show that when you truly believe from the bottom of your heart that all the blessings you have are coming only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As he says, وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Whatever of blessings you have are coming only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's how you show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in regard of your heart. And when you come to the second pillar, which is the tongue that everyone has. How could I show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the tongue, by my tongue? When you talk with the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon you, and you refer these blessings to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will be among the ones who are showing gratitude by the tongue. You know, in Surah Al-Duha, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned couple of ni'am, couple of blessings that he bestowed upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then at the end of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. Like, speak with the blessings. Ya Muhammad, speak with the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon you. That's why Al-Khalifa Umar bin Abdul Aziz rahimahullah, he used to say, تَذَاكَرُ النِّعَمْ. Remind one another with the blessings that you have. Why? قَالْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَهَا شُكْرٌ. The act when you remind one another with the blessings, it will be considered as an act of showing gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But sometimes, my dear brothers and sisters, we do mistakes when we mention the blessings. You know, me and some of you, or the majority, came from our homelands and we don't have nothing. Or we don't have what we have right now. And day after day, time after time, week after week, year after year, we have these blessings. We taste, we touch, we feel these blessings that we don't have before. House, car, or cars. Wife, children, business, or businesses. And when we come to mention these blessings, sometimes we do mistakes. We refer all these blessings for our efforts. I did so much. I spent tireless effort to build this business, to build this house, to purchase all this land, and so on. So, and we never, or sometimes we forget to refer these blessings to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. Here is the mistake. You should remind yourself Once you remember a blessing, don't refer to yourself first. Refer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then you mention your effort, or your wife's efforts, or your parents' efforts, your friends' efforts. It's okay at that moment. But don't refer that to your effort first. Always you should remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you mention these blessings. And you know, some other times the people, they don't, and they undervalue the blessings. You know, like I heard this statement many times when I ask people, how are you? How is your business? How is like they working with you? And sometimes I listen or I heard, alhamdulillah, no compliment. No complaint. Alhamdulillah, there is no complaint. I say, you have already complained. Or, alhamdulillah, it can be better. My dear brothers and sisters, watch your words before saying it. When you say these words, no complain, or it can be better, or anything else, that show you're trying to say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I deserve more than what I have. But you are not. You don't deserve what you have. We don't deserve to be here in this life, except with the mercy and the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be here. So always, when you mention the blessings, and when you try to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you should remember that you have to thank Him without qualification nor negation. You always have to say Alhamdulillah and stop there. That's when we come to the part, the second part of showing gratitude by the tongue. The third part, or the third pillar, is by action. How can show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by an action? We have a good example in front of us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the people of Dawood alayhi salam in the Quran in Surah 7. He says, اعملوا آل داود شكرا. He's addressing Prophet Dawood and his family to work hard. That will be considered as an act of showing gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Working hard like what? I'm going to give you a simple example. Working up for the Fajr, especially within this cold time in the winter season. It's hard to wake up and then to make wudu. That will be considered as an act of showing gratitude by the action. Or when you work hard day and night, and you don't have that enough income, and then there is an opportunity in front of you to make charity to one of your relatives or one of your family members, that will be considered as an act of showing gratitude by the action. Or when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you position, not anyone else has this position. Do you use that position to help people? To make everything easy for them, or to make it hard for them? Or when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you lisan hilo, moist tongue, do you use that tongue for the sake of Allah? Do you use that tongue to spread kind words among the people? or you spread fitna, bad words between people. And there are many, many things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you to show gratitude by an action, day and night. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the shakirin and dhakirin, and to thank him as he deserves. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من الشاكرين الذاكرين أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا أما بعد. We have highlighted about how to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether by heart, tongue, and or an action. But always we are looking for an approval, a sign that shows you are among the shakirin or not. You are among the one who are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not. So what is that sign that shows you are among the shakirin? The sign is to be thankful and grateful to the ones around you. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that clearly in one of authentic hadith. مَنْ لَا يَشْكُرِ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرِ اللَّهِ. The ones who don't thank people, they don't thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means if you don't thank people for any favor they are doing for you, you are not thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here is the question that we should ask ourselves. Do we practice that in our life, day and night? I don't like to go far away, just with your family members. Do you thank your wife when she cooks? يسلموا إيديكي يعطيك العافية or not? Do you thank your son or daughter when he helped you or she helped you in your house or in your work or anywhere else? Or you always think for the woman as well, because I have to make balance, right? Do you thank your husband when he comes back from the work? Or he has to work, I don't have to thank him. When we deal with our family members, I'm dealing with him, with them, in the way that I deserve all of these services, or no, I have to stop from dealing with them in this way. You should stop. You have to stop in dealing with your family members in the way that I deserve to be served. No. This is not the way. This is not the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So be thankful to the ones around you to be among the ones who are thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And since we are talking about Thanksgiving and all of this stuff, just a reminder, we don't say like it's haram to like celebrate or to do something on coming Thursday and to invite your family, because it's not related to religion. It's like national day here, and it's okay to gather with your family members and to eat turkey or anything else, but don't add something haram on the side. Remember, you can celebrate any day and any night, but don't add haram stuff to your celebration to feel like something or to reach that level of happiness. This is my humble request from each one of us, each one of you. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us always among the shakirin, ya rabbal alameen. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ صَلَّى عَلَى نَبِيِّكُمْ قَدِيمًا وَلَمْ يَزَلْ قَائِلًا عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا لَبَيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ صَلِّ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِ مُحَمَّدٍ كَمَا صَلَّيْتَ عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَعَلَى آلِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِنَّكَ حَمِيدٌ مَجِيدٌ اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين وأعلي بفضلك وكلمتك راية الحق والدين اللهم أرنا الإسلام عزيزا يا عزيز اللهم ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم ولا تعذبنا فإنك علينا قادر والطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير ودبر لنا يا مولانا فإنا لا نحسن التدبير اللهم ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم لا تعذبنا فإنك علينا قادر اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا ولا تؤاخذنا بما فعل ويفعل السفهاء منا اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعل اجتماعنا هذا اجتماعا مرحوما تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما ربنا اغفر لنا ولأبائنا وأمهاتنا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا وارزقنا برهم أحيانا وأمواتا أمين يا رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة